Today on Glove Affairs, let's talk about three-time world champion Terry Norris.
Terry Norris. Terrible Tim, TNT indeed, and what a dynamite fucking fighter he was. Shout outs first and foremost to my man, who I can't even remember whose name he is, but you know who I'm talking about, who actually requested for me to do this about a week ago. And boy, is it a pleasure. Now, first and foremost, I thought like Norris was a dominated fighter, one of the best junior middleweights of all time, bar none and stuff. And it was only a shame for the way that his career ended up transpiring, playing and playing out as far as like his condition today. To me, that's fucking heartbreaking and stuff. Like, this dude was actual animal in there. And mind you, he came from being a baseball player. He was a college baseball player who took his talents and everything, and he just happened to be a dude who got into a whole lot of fights and decided to take that and construct it. Came over with his brother Orlin and everything, Orlin Norris, and they became like big splashes in the sport, respectively, what Orlin did in the heavyweight division as well. I thought that was crazy about it. I always wanted him to get that shot with Chavez Jr. For whatever happened, that shot didn't turn out. That would have been one hell of a fight. Norris was gifted with like every ability in the ring. Most people got familiar with him after he like decimated Ray Leonard, who was an aging version of himself and everything, but Norris put on a classic. He showed he had the hand speed, he had the combinations, he had a little bit of the flair, he had the overall ring IQ. He was well schooled. He knew how to get inside. He knew how to like turn people with his shots, and like he knew how to like change positions on the inside. He was a very sound fighter. I thought from time to time he would have momentary lapses, or that temperament would get the best of him. And I think that if he had any like stylistic weakness, and it was crazy like seeing him fight Mildred Taylor, who was like an idol to me and shit. And what was crazy was they both had that same similar temperament. They both had the skill sets, but that dynamic, sometimes their heart would betray them. Sometimes they wanted to get in there and mix, or maybe they should tie up, maybe they should go out and reset. I thought Norris would have temporary lapses that would cause him crucial fights that kind of like took a hindrance on his legacy, but it's like everybody could see what that ability was. I wish we had him here today. I think he was one generation too soon. I would have loved to see him fight Jamal Charlo and Jamel Charlo and mix it up with Arislandi Lara and see him with Andrade and Canelo and stuff like that. He was that talented of a fighter. I thought that his temperament betrayed him. And, you know, we know the Santana fights, the early disqualifications and stuff. I remember when he fought Paul Vaden. Y'all remember that and stuff? When Paul Vaden actually slept with his wife, had an affair with his wife, and he went in there and wanted to make a point and punished him over 12 rounds and stuff and did it brutally. I thought, like, you know, he had his situations. A lot of his fights were momentary lapses. You look at the Julian Jackson fight. He was arguably winning that fight. In fact, most people had him ahead at the time. Ran into a shot along the ropes, and we all know what happens when the Hulk lands a flush hammer and everything, ends up getting put out. Simon Brown put him down and everything, knocked him out in a fight that he was winning as well, then he was winning as well. But on the same note, if you want to flip it around, Norris showed you what he can do when he's fully focused in that rematch, and he beat Simon quite decisively. You know, the Troy Walters fight was another example and everything. I think sometimes where he would, you know, he would want to engage and everything when he should probably disassemble or everything, or he would want to, like, you know what I mean, sometimes that heart would get the best of him. He was taught that Mexican fighting style and everything from Abel Sanchez. And by the way, Sanchez is a piece of shit. Let me explain something else about that. For him to get up there on that fucking Charlo fight when Charlo was trying to fight Triple G, and they turned around and dodged and came up with every fucking excuse they could to stop the fight, and he gets up there talking about some black fighters don't sell pay-per-view tickets. But everybody gets so upset, you know, when it's a Devin Haney, when Hopkins says, I'll never let the white boy beat me, or something else happens. For him to get up there saying that, given the fact that he was the one in the first place, that who would Abel Sanchez be if it wasn't for Terry Norris and Orlin Norris? If it wasn't for his initial success with that, who would he be in the sport right now? I wonder how Terry would feel about him saying that. To know that you sat there and let him get his head beat in for everything that he's going through right now, and his messed up speech impediment and everything else that's going on with his health, just for you to turn around and talk about how black fighters weren't meant to be pay-per-view draws in the first place. So I guess you never even had those hopes for him, huh? I guess he would have never got a Triple G fight either while he was your fighter. I guess he would have never got in there with Canelo. Anyway, I mean, Norris was a phenomenal fighter overall. Like I said, I wish he would have got the Chavez fight. Granted, it was kind of later in Chavez's career, and Chavez did his thing at lightweight, came all the way up to welter. You can't necessarily blame him and say that he necessarily ignored the fight and everything, and his resume speaks for itself. But I thought that Norris was extraordinary. Norris had talents and everything. The only thing is, like I said, he had the Mildred complex. He had the speed to be able to get over and everything. Remember how Mildred fought Chavez, and he's 11 rounds, damn near like 11 rounds ahead in the fight? And all he had to do was pretty much play the prevent defense and stop from getting himself knocked out in the last round. But he had to go in there and prove that point. And I think sometimes that pride got the best of him, that angry foot with it. But that was also what made him the great champion he was. So yeah, I'm an absolute fan of Norris. Salute to whoever asked me to do this in the first place. By the way, on a side note, we're going to try to hit y'all with some footage pretty soon so we can bring y'all in the living room and try to show you a little more glimpse into what I'm trying to describe when I'm telling y'all some of the action in this fight so you just don't see a motherfucker sitting inside a chair. Anyway, y'all tell me what y'all think. Drop your comments. Holler when you holler.